going to try a few different things on this Shikishi board. I have a few pieces. So let's just get creative and see what happens. I'm going to take my watercolor brush and just some clean water and start by wetting this board as if rice paper was not completely absorbent enough. I'm going to show you what happens when I just draw straight on the rice paper, because it is super absorbent and it just sucks up the liquid really fast, which means that if you have pigment, it gets slurped up as well. For things to move around in. And set that one aside to let it dry. I've been staring at this one trying to figure out what to do with it, and I think it needs more layers before I can really find the shapes. Let's wet it down again. And then start with my blue once more. A little bit too wet there. I think I see this curved tree trunk. That stretches up into this dark blue canopy. Some of the browns into that said canopy. For some variation. A little bit of gray to blend these lower areas and to do some ground. I think I'd like a little bit of blue as well. Let that blend and bleed upward. So in order for that to happen, it needs to have a little bit more water here just along the base. And then when I drag my brush tip along the bottom and I let things dry with a slight tilt in this direction, that should let the pigment sort of bleed upwards in that direction. And that will give me a nice sort of ground area. So I'm going to set this aside and let it dry with this tilted orientation. Is now looking much more like a place. I would like to start and using the brown and pulling out some really fine twiggy details. contrast of the much darker, more concentrated ink that I'm drawing now versus the very diffuse and misty looking colors and tones that have been set into the initial layers that I created by doing a wet and wet. Contrast of this really adds depth in a very simple way. I mean, it doesn't take much to do that. You just have to layer these blurred areas with very sharply delineated stuff, and you get this effect of distance in a piece. It's just that contrast that creates that illusion. That's what painting and drawing is all about, right? It's just all creating illusions of dimensionality on a piece of paper. I'm taking my blue now and doing the same with the tree trunk, just adding more defined edges and lines so that the beautiful blurred stuff there becomes texture and shadow. This to blend downwards. So I'm adding some water here. And that way, when I drag my brush through that area, it sort of bleeds out, but then turns to much more fine lines as I get towards the dry areas of my paper. Next, I'm going to take some Daniel Smith clear watercolor ground. And paint a layer over these areas where I want to be able to do finer detail in my next round after things dry.